My name is Martijn Zwart. I'm a senior solutions consultant at Thomson Reuters, and I will provide an introduction and demonstration of the HiQ platform. But first, I will explain something around the basics of HiQ. It's important to understand how the platform is really set up. With HiQ, you can create your legal operations hub, with the idea to centralize all of your legal work in one and the same platform. In that platform, you can create different type of solutions, but all those solutions exist of the same building blocks, or Lego blocks, as we like to call them, to build out different type of solutions. And this creates a very flexible system. So for example, you can create a contract review platform, you can organize your contract management, create a legal intake process, or organize your matter management. Now, all of those solutions, they exist of those same building blocks, but we just use them differently, or we choose different elements to choose from them. We also have some premium modules, for example, like data visualization, the use of artificial intelligence, workflows to really make most use and organize your organization in the most efficient way. Now, today, I will show you some examples of how you can collaborate in the platform and how you can extend that efficiency in your legal department using HiQ. So now over to the demonstration part, and we're going to start with a working from home situation. Now, when everyone is working from home, it can be a bit of a challenge to get a good overview on who's doing what and how your work is distributed between your members of your team. In HiQ, we can create a central place where people can work together, collaborate on documents, assign tasks, and even assign a particular workflow to approve on certain tasks. And we can see here a bit of a dashboard of that legal team that we're working with. So we have an overview on the things that we are working on. We have a breakdown of work on the team members. We can see that Carol is rather busy at the moment compared to the other team members. And we have feed on some new Corona news in the Netherlands here. And on the right side, we also have a feed of recent documents that were uploaded in the platform and that we want to collaborate on or assign tasks related to those documents. Now, on top of that, we can also create a breakdown, for example, on region or on business lines, departments that we want to report upon. And everything you see here is just an example of the dashboards that we can create. It's very easy to customize these dashboards. You don't have to be an IT specialist to work on that. So it's, as we say, it's built by lawyers for lawyers in the HiQ system. So it's also easy to create your own insights or your own legal cockpit, really, on this. What I want to show you here is how we can upload some documents in the platform. We can create a central place, maybe some different areas of legal work that we want to collaborate upon. So for example, if I want to establish a bit of workflow for some contract review, I can upload, in this case, an NDA here, maybe something we have received from a supplier. And I want to make sure that one of my team members is going to work on this. So every team member has access to this site. We can, if we want, even limit down the access rights to some of those folders here. I will not go into too much depth on this in this demonstration, but it's good to be aware of that. And what I want to do here is assign a task, in this case, to my team member, Malcolm. I want to assign a task to him to review this NDA, and I want him to do that well, starting actually tomorrow. So for example, in this case, I want him to do that starting on Friday, and maybe I want him to finish on that next Tuesday. I'm going to assign this, in this case, to Malcolm. I know he's a good guy on this. I'm going to assign this to our contract review type of work. And I can also provide some further details on this. So for example, I've gotten this requirement from procurement. They're based, in this case, for example, in Germany. And everything you see here is just some custom tasks that you can create, or some custom task metadata, I have to say. And you can make sure that you customize this to your organization. So this also bit as an intake form. We can also indicate a request on this. This is not an urgent request right now. And I want to make sure that Malcolm does this also before Monday. So I also want to make sure that I set some reminders for him because, well, I know how Malcolm works. And we can also see that once I add this task, that the documents related to this task will automatically be attached to that, and Malcolm will receive an email with a link to this task and making it possible for him to access this platform. And the platform you see here, it's you can access this, as you can see, just in your browser. So it's no need to install anything. You can access this at any moment in time from any device, really. So also from your mobile phone. What we can now see here is that once we get an overview of the work that we are doing, we can see the work assigned to me. We can see an overview of all the tasks that can, for example, be helpful for the team leader, the GC. They want to get that oversight, but people individually might want to drill down on their tasks. We can see that review of the NDA visible here. We can also see a very basic overview of tasks that we deal with. So we have things to do, think in progress. We have some approval stage here and complete stage. And what I want to do here is just make sure that Malcolm is working on this. Now imagine that Malcolm is dragging this work to another status. We can then all see what the progress is on this. You may might compare this a bit, for example, to the Trello kind of feeling. So it has that same functionality, the same intuitiveness in it. And now fast forward a bit in, say, the review on this document that that Malcolm is working on. We can co-author on the document, we can make markups. I will not go in too much detail on this now, but fasting forward to the fact that Malcolm did his review on the NDA, and now he says, well, actually, I want this document to be reviewed by my manager. So I'm dragging that to a new phase to requires approval stage, and we will see then that while this document or this task was first assigned to Malcolm, it will now be assigned to Stephen, who is the head of legal and who wants to make sure that he signs off on that NDA. We can also see notifications happening on that, for example, that once a task is assigned, that people get a reminders on that. So also in the system itself, you can see the things that are happening here. So it's a bit of a first example of how you can make sure that you track the documents, track the work in your legal department, get that oversight and see a basic example of the type of workflows that we can use in the HighQ system. Of course, this is just, let's say, a basic step that we can show you. And I want to jump actually to a Legadex example where we use some more advanced workflows. And what we see here is an example of a contract review and contract management solution where Legadex will be able to support you on. You can see here an example of the different stages that a contract can go through. We can see quite similarly a breakdown of tasks, and we can see a preview also of the use of artificial intelligence to speed up on the contract review as well. Including a breakdown of contracts, languages, but also here you could create a breakdown, for example, on contracts with for which a change control has been found or a force majeure clause. All of these things are, again, customizable and just provide you an insight on, in this case, your contract management and review solution. What I want to do now is take you a bit through that journey by uploading a document and going through the different stages that we have set up here. Again, this is just an example of how you could structure your contract management. It's just also something you can combine with other workflows and really tailor them to your internal organization. Now, what we do now is upload an agreement here. So I'm going to upload, in this case, a franchise agreement that we have to go through. And I want to make sure that I also capture the relevant contract data. And we will see just by uploading this document, I can do that, for example, either from my local drive, but also we have an Outlook plugin worth mentioning that you can use to easily drag and drop documents into the contract management solution or into the HighQ platform. And we can see here that once this document is uploaded, that also automatically a task has been assigned to me, assigning to me, hey, you must be sure to also complete the contract metadata for this contract. So I can go here to have a look at this document, complete my task here to make sure that we capture that relevant data. Now, while I'm opening up this document, you can see here on the right side that we have a checklist for us to complete. I can here, for example, include the contract value. I can select the contract type. So in this case, this is a franchise agreement. We can include the contract status here. I can include counterparty details. Again, everything you see here, just an example of something that you can include. And we can also say, hey, who's going to handle this contract? In this case, that will be me. But you can also allocate that, for example, to a different colleague who you think should work upon this. But you can also combine that with different colleagues at the same time. If I know what is going to be an effective date, I can also already include that here. And again, it's just an example of the contract data fields that you can include, and also as we have seen with Endemol, they are able to customize that really to their internal needs. So I think that's really worth mentioning, that HiQ system is very flexible on making sure that your contract management system is to be able to configure it to your needs. Now, while I'm saving this information for this contract data, and we have that information, that also helps us to search for our contracts, search for the relevant contracts with advanced search queries. And I can go back and have a look at that document to see now which contract information is now included. We can also see here that the documents that are created also have different statuses that we can have a look at. And I want to make sure that we have a central repository for all of the documents, but now in a bit of a more contract database. So what we see here, it's the same documents as you saw in this document repository, but now we have a clear overview on all of the documents and the different statuses of those contracts. So what I want to do now is actually take this to the next step and say, well, I've worked on the document. Again, imagine that you're, for example, use Office Online to co-author on the documents, which we can integrate within HiQ as well. And imagine that both Amin and I have worked on this document, but now we say, hey, actually, we want to go to the next stage. But before we go to the negotiation phase, we want to make sure that we get the required approval on the content of this document. You can imagine maybe what's going to happen, because once I go refresh on this document, you can see a notification about the fact that task has been assigned. In this case, that's to me, because I'm the contract approver on this. And I want to make sure that this contract goes has its review. And we can go here, we can see that this contract requires approval, so we can include specific messages by way of our workflow engine based on just the status change of a contract. I can go here, filter out that only document to make sure that I can approve on that. And well, if I do approve, we can say, well, we can change that here easily and directly into the screen. We can, for example, move it to the negotiation phase. With our new workflow engine, also the fact that you change the status can also move a document to a different folder, which is quite a helpful feature. But let us now fast forward to the phase that we agree upon this document and want to make sure that we go, say, to the next cycle of this contract. Once refreshing, quite similarly, we can now see that a task will be assigned, for example, to the contract handlers. So Amin will also get an email about the fact that we go to a different stage in this contract. We are both assigned to this task created by our workflow engine, indicating to us that this Arya Stark contract, in this example, has to be signed. We can go here to access the contract and make sure that we can sign this contract. When it comes to signing, it's also worth mentioning that within HiQ, you're able to integrate, for example, with DocuSign and Adobe Sign. That also helps you to be even more efficient in your in the contract lifecycle, because you speed up also on the signing of that. And for example, once you do that, you can also get a clear history on the audit history. So for example, also if you create new versions of a document, you can see who made changes, which changes were made. We also have comparison functionality. But if you then also, say, at the end of a contract lifecycle, sign the contract through DocuSign, you can see that action in the audit of the HiQ platform, making sure that you see that. And then once signed, the document will get a new version, PDF version, that will no longer be able to be adjusted, of course. And this is an example of the stages that those contracts can go through. Of course, once you have executed contracts or you acquire, say, a new business and you have to review those contracts, you may also have contracts that you have to review, or there are contracts that you have obligations to check upon. For example, those renewal dates. Also there, we have a possibility to make sure that we have an efficient way of making sure that those documents that are, for example, up for renewal are indicated to you in time. And we can use a date trigger for that as well. So that means, for example, if we have a renewal date here, and imagine that kind of change that bit to somewhere in July, because I know we have that coming up. I can now simulate the action that HiQ can help you with, which basically is that once a contract renewal is up, we can set a trigger for that a renewal date that makes sure that, for example, that if today is 90 days before that renewal date, that automatically a task is created by our automation engine assigning or indicating to me, and in this case Hans Martijn, that this contract is up for renewal. We have a due date that is make sure that it is 30 days before the actual renewal date, and then we can make sure that we are in time to look upon that contract. So the workflow engine that we have can exist both of changing the status in the contract, the upload of a document, but also a date trigger, which really makes sure that you are in control and you get the required notifications about those contracts. As said, when it comes down to your contracts, it can also be that you have contracts to review upon. And what you can see here is that within the HiQ platform, we can make sure that once you have documents to review, we can also create a bit of a preview and a helpful checklist on the contracts that you have to review. And we can see here in a different section that once I am performing my contract review, you can also score and indicate for the contract that have a particular issue directly next to the document. So you can go through, you can annotate even in the contract. And we can say here, for example, if this document has an issue, yes or no. And we can make sure that we flag on these contracts, maybe even have some red flagging there and indicate the comments related to those contracts. But what you can see here as well is that we can also combine that, for example, with the artificial intelligence engine. Because if you look at the use of AI, we can also see, well, once, for example, a change of control has been found, we can use that to make a pre-selection of documents that we want to look at first. And that means that looking at, say, the contracts in our contract repository, and also, say, all the executed documents that you may have that you want to check upon for risk management, then the HiQ AI engine can help you to make that pre-selection for you. So we can process documents. We can also integrate, for example, with Kira, Leverton, and Eigen. And we can use then those engines to process the documents that are stored in HiQ. And then the processed information comes back to the HiQ platform. And we can see here a bit of a preview on that. So we have some change controls that have been found either with a yes, no, or with a particular clause, the governing law, jurisdiction, all that information can be found in the contract and be used also to smartly configure also views on that asset going back to the dashboard. Any type of contract data really can be used to visualize. So also here, this is just an example of what you may want to zoom in upon and also use to track on the status of that AI. And based on that, you can also think of, say, particular information on your contract review. So if you want to follow the process of the contract review performed by LegaDex, you can also create a centralized overview to you as a client, where you can, for example, have a look at the process of that. You can log in anytime and have to see, hey, what is the progress? Or we can use this to discuss and say, well, actually, we don't think this is a red flag. Let's change that. So things like that, it's very, very easy to work upon, to co-work, especially with everyone working from home nowadays. So HiQ and the LegaDex platform can provide you with that efficient way of working, indicating to you here some examples of say the basic things like assigning work, setting those approval workflows, or really just working on a document to co-author. But everything going back to the platform is based around building blocks. So these are some examples of how you can work with the platform. But there are other use cases like legal service requests, matter management, data rooms, and go on. Just happy to share you some examples of the HiQ platform by way of this webinar. So thank you very much.